皆さんおはようございます。このように多くの皆様にご参加いただいてありがとうございます。昨年第10回が国際大会ということで、多くの方々が英語でされたということで非常に感銘を受けまして、そして今回もできることなら国際会のその、バージョンを続けたいということで、お話が決まりましたでありますので、私どもの挨拶も英語でさせていただくということになりましたので、よろしくお願い申し上げます。 I'm very glad to see you so many participants here at the 11th Grand Contest on Chemistry for High School Students. On the behalf of Osaka City University, one of the organization of this event, I'd like to make an opening address.Last year, we held a dance contest and made it an international contest. Nine overall presentation team out of 10 Japanese high school students team presented their results in English, completely or partially. It was very impressive for us, and I felt high challenging spirit.And high potential towards cosmopolitan. There is a proverb, strike while iron is hot. 鉄は熱いうちでということわざがあります。Strike while the iron is hot. We believe that, it is important to encourage high school students towards giving an international environment and stage in the contest.So we decided to continue to the spirit of the 10th Grand Contest, that is, making the contest international. So we decided to continue the spirit of, in order to give a chance of international communication to all participants. We invited one excellent team from the Taiwan and one outstanding team from the Singapore.In this year, like the last time. In addition to invitation of the foreign teams to the contest, we bought a route to send the Japanese team to the international event in the foreign country. And we are very happy to announce you that one of the best teams of the contest is supposed to be invited to the Taiwan International Science Fair, like the last time.Moreover, another team among the best team of the contest will be invited to an International Science Youth Forum, which will be held in Singapore in next January. As my last remark, I'd like to express my sincere gratitude to the guest speakers and referees for their participation despite of their busy schedule.And also I'd like to thank the many organizations and the corporations for supporting this forum. I hope that all presenters will do their best and gain the fruitful result. Thank you very much.
今西田先生おっしゃったように私も英語でということでご理解いただきたいと思います。 Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very pleased to have you here. And my name is Okuno, the president of Osaka Prefecture University. On behalf of our university, this university is just making the meeting hereSo please enjoy the 1 day or 2 days here, and it's a very nice autumn day. Thank you again for coming to our university or to our campus. Today we have around maybe 400 people here. This contest is expanded to the all of Japan from This year, the plum sandai in this northern part of Japan and in Kyushu or Shikoku, the whole of Japan. And as already Nishizawa sensei has mentioned, the last year we have a very anniversary 10th of this contest. So that time we invited the beyond the border, not only Japan, but also the other international relationship we have. This year, very fortunate we have another chance to international fellowship with Singapore and Taiwan. It is, I should say that it is possible to that kind of international fellowship owing to the JST, Japan Science and Technology Agency that fund, that they have a fund. So we apply that, this project, and very fortunate we have that financial support here. So it's very fortunate we can invite the two groups from Taiwan and Singapore. That program is called Japan, but in Japanese, Sakura Project or something. Sakura is just a cherry blossom. But in English, Japan, Asia Youth Exchange Program in Science. That is the correct name. So you understand that this project, that project, JST project, is fellowship with another country, particularly the Asian country. So I'm very suitable for that. So we are very pleased to get some kind of the financial support. As you know, that many countries, not only Japan, but also Japanese government, concentrate to the international fellowship to encourage that. So many universities that, as we know, the same thing. And so you can always hear that global age or some borderless age or something. Now we are in the borderless society now, but we have to develop that system. And I should say that the very long time before, we have already had some borderless age. That is the 12th century to 14th century. University is have been started the 12th century in Italy. It's very famous in the name of the city is So anyway, the language and Italy there. Bologna. It's a famous, it's a Bologna. We have started the university there. At that time, everybody used in the university, everybody used the language, it's common language, it's Latin. But of course, the Italy, France, or there's many languages there, but in the university, the Latin, only Latin language is used. So, many universities are in the European country, but students very easily to move to many universities, many countries, but because of Latin, just one language. At that time, it's very, we should say that is the borderless society or global society that. Now we have another global age here. So many young people, we have to stick that there. So the language should be English. If you if you use that one language, of course you can image the academic field or study field, no border, no border. Yes, maybe you agree with me. This research work or academic field with principally we do not have a border. So I would like to say that in this next future society, in order to develop that the next future society, you, the young people, young students, have to have overcome that this for this global age, I think. So I believe that you will, or you can go further easily, because if you speak just one language, it's common language, so that you can overcome the English. It's okay, I think. So many young people do that. I hope you will have a nice time and nice experience in this contest. Thank you very much indeed.
Good morning, my name is Yasuhi Kinami. I'm the science editor of the Yomiuri Shimbun Osaka. For those who came all the way from Taiwan and Singapore background, first of all, I'd like to congratulate you all that you are giving me your made great achievements. And you should be proud of your service. I'm very much looking forward to the upcoming oral presentations. This year, we received great news for the Japanese scientific community. Three scientists from Japan were awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics for developing the blue light emitting diode, now widely known as LEDs. The research had long been expected to win Nobel Prize either in physics or chemistry. Professor Sano Akasaki of Meiji University, one of the three laureates, said in an interview after the announcement, "I could keep doing this because this was what I wanted to do and what I loved to do." It has been said that the development of blue LEDs was impossible during the 20th century. By doing what he loved to do, Professor Saki made what people had believed to be impossible possible. Doing what you love to do, you may not feel the hardships as much. I think this is a very important aspect. Another laureate, Professor Hiroshi Amano of Nagoya University, said, "If you live up to your dream, you will succeed. You just have to not give up." The winner of the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 2002 was Koichi Tanaka, now senior fellow of Shimakura Prefecture. And you can make a breakthrough discovery with his work. Some of you may dream of becoming great researchers in the future. Don't hesitate to pursue your dreams, but go for it. You have infinite possibilities, but don't forget to write hard on English as great. 以上、ゆきなり科学部長のメッセージを代読させていただきました。それではここで第11回高校科学グランドコンテストに寄せられました橋本徹大阪市長からのメッセージを私より代読させていただきます。第11回高校科学グランドコンテスト最終選考会が盛大に開催されますことを心よりお祝い申し上げます。高校生の皆さんが科学の分野における疑問や身近なテーマを探求した成果をここに発表されますことは誠に意義深く、本コンテストの企画開催にご尽力されました関係者の皆様に深く敬意を表し感謝申し上げます。大阪市はグローバル化の進展など社会が大きく変化していく中にあっては、人材育成の基盤である教育事業の推進が最重要課題であると認識しています。引き続き大阪市立大学の県立団体として、高校生の皆さんが科学をはじめとするさまざまな分野に興味を持ち、豊かな想像力と学ぶ意欲を高められるような大学の知見を生かした魅力的な事業の実施の支援に力を尽くしてまいります。最終選考会に臨む皆さんには、これまでの努力と研究の成果を堂々と発表していただき、このコンテストの経験を糧にさらに科学をはじめとする未来の自然科学の発展に貢献する意気込みで学業に精励されますことを期待しております。最後になりましたが、本コンテストの今後ますますのご発展と、またご臨席の皆様方の一層のご健勝ご多幸を心からお祈り申し上げ、お祝いの言葉とさせていただきます。橋本徹大阪市長。続きまして、松井一郎大阪府知事からのメッセージを代読させていただきます。第11回高校科学グランドコンテストの開催を心よりお祝い申し上げます。本コンテストは科学を学ぶ意欲の高揚や豊かな想像力を育む場として毎年数多くの高校生が参加されています。今年度も全体に引き続き国際大会として開催され、体育館及びシンガポールからも高校生を招聘されており、海外の高校生との交流の場としても誠に意義深いものと思います。先日、実用的な青色発光ダイオード LED を開発した3人の日本人科学者へのノーベル物理学賞の授与が決定されました。 LED は私たちの生活において特に身近なものであり、子どもから大人までの幅広い年齢層の中で話題になっています。日本の研究者の受賞は誠に誇らしいことであり、今後とも我が国の研究者の方々が世界の科学技術の発展をリードしていくことを期待しています。こうした中、今回も全国から多数の応募があったと伺っています。皆さんの探究心や想像力に感嘆するとともに、この経験を生かして将来さまざまな分野で活躍されることを大変楽しみにしています。大阪府では世界で活躍するグローバル人材の育成をはじめ、府民の皆さんが安全安心に暮らせる優しい大阪、府民の皆さんが誇れる強い大阪の実現に全力を尽くしてまいります。皆様には引き続き府政の推進にご理解とご協力のほどよろしくお願い申し上げます。本日最終選考会に臨まれる皆さんには、これまでの努力と研究の成果を十分発揮していただくとともに、このコンテストを通じてさらに科学に対する理解を広げられ、学業に一層励まれることを期待します。最後に、本日お集まりの皆さんのますますのご活躍を記念しまして、お祝いの言葉とさせていただきます。松井一郎大阪府知事からのメッセージでした。